Hi, Academy. My name is Bhoomika, and in this chapter, we'll be dealing with the endomembranal system or the endomembrane system. Now, this one is not just a single organelle. It is a group of organelles which kind of function together, and they're kind of connected together. So we're going to know more about this. Let's get started. What is the endomembranal system? The endomembranal system is a group of membranes and organelles in the eukaryotic cell that works together to modify, package, and transport lipids and proteins. It includes a variety of organelles such as the nuclear envelope and lysosomes, which you may have already known, and the endoplasmic reticulum and the Golgi apparatus, which we will cover shortly. Okay, so although it's not technically inside the cell, the plasma membrane is also a part of the endomembranal system. As we'll see, the plasma membrane interacts with the other endomembranal organelles, and it's the site where secreted proteins are exported. So the endomembranal system does not include the mitochondria, chloroplasts, or peroxisomes. So we'll study about the endomembranal system, which has the basic components of the endoplasmic reticulum. It's the major one. Now the endomembranal system, it also consists of the nuclear pores, but because we have already done nucleus in the second lesson, you are supposed to do it from there itself, so I'm not including the nuclear pore here. We are straight away going to begin with the endoplasmic reticulum, and then we'll follow up with the Golgi apparatus and then the lysosomes. Also, at the end of the lesson, we are going to do a comparison between two organelles which sound and perform similar functions, the lysosomes and the peroxisomes. But you need to know that peroxisomes are not included in the endomembranal system, so you have to keep that in mind. Alright, so here we have a diagram of the cell, and basically this is the endomembranal system. You can see the nucleus right here, this is the nucleolus right here, and then we have the nuclear envelope, and the nuclear pores are also easily visible. So from the nuclear envelope, you can see some ribosomes which are coming out, and just attached to the nuclear envelope we have the rough endoplasmic reticulum, and then after that we have the smooth endoplasmic reticulum. We have certain secretory vesicles also, and a lysosome is clearly visible. After that, this big green colored structure is the Golgi apparatus, and the plasma membrane is also visible. So this is the diagram of the endomembranal system. Now let's see this in this one. We have the nuclear envelope right here, the nucleus is present. Attached to it we have the rough endoplasmic reticulum right here, and here, because ribosomes are not attached, this is the smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Now we have some lysosomes present here and right here. These discs, they are of the Golgi complex. Some vesicles are also present, and this is the plasma membrane. Okay, so let's talk about the endoplasmic reticulum. It plays a key role in modification of proteins and synthesis of lipids. It consists of a network of membranous tubules and flattened discs. So the ER, it kind of is composed of tubules and flattened discs. The discs and tubules of the ER are hollow, and the space inside them is termed as lumen. So let's talk about the two types of endoplasmic reticulum. One is the smooth one and one is the rough one. The rough endoplasmic reticulum gets its name from the bumpy ribosomes attached to its cytoplasmic surface. So the surface of an endoplasmic reticulum, if it has got number of ribosomes studded onto it, then it forms the rough endoplasmic reticulum. As these ribosomes make proteins, they feed the newly forming protein chains into the lumen. Some are transferred fully into the ER and float inside, while others are anchored in the membrane. So inside the ER, the protein fold and undergoes modifications such as the addition of carbohydrate side chain. These modified proteins will be incorporated into cellular membranes, the membrane of the ER or those of the other organelles, or secreted from the cell. So basically the ER, the rough endoplasmic reticulum, are actually the site of modification of proteins. So some proteins, they get carbohydrate chains attached to it, some proteins get lipid chains attached to them. So all these modifications, they take place inside the lumen of the endoplasmic reticulum. If the modified protein are not destined to stay in the ER, they will be packaged into vesicles or small spheres of membrane that are used for transport, and then they will be shipped to Golgi apparatus. So once the proteins are modified, they are either supposed to stay in the ER or they're supposed to be transported to other organelle. So if they stay in the ER, then obviously they'll stay there and perform their own functions from that side particularly. But if they are not supposed to stay for the stay inside the ER, they are kind of carried into small vesicles, and these vesicles, they carry these proteins to the Golgi apparatus. The rough endoplasmic reticulum also makes phospholipids for the other cellular membranes, which are transported when the vesicle forms. Since the rough ER helps modify proteins that will be secreted from the cells whose job is to secrete large amount of enzymes or other proteins, such as liver cells, have a lot of rough ER. So obviously we told you that the rough endoplasmic reticulum is associated with modification of proteins, and enzymes mostly are proteins. So a number of cells which are present in the liver, they have lots of rough ER because they have to secrete large amounts of enzymes and other proteins. So that is the reason why their cells, they have humongous amount of ER. Now let's talk about the smooth endoplasmic reticulum. It's a continuous with the rough endoplasmic reticulum, but it has very few or absolutely nil ribosomes on its cytoplasmic surface. Functions of the smooth ER. First function is synthesis of carbohydrates, lipids and steroid hormones. Okay, synthesis. So carbohydrates, lipids and certain hormones are synthesized or produced in the Golgi apparatus. Detoxification of medications and poisons, storage of calcium ions. So a person will ingest a number of medicines throughout his lifetime. So after digestion or something, these may become intoxicated. Okay, so in order to remove these toxins, the Golgi apparatus, they are involved in detoxification of medications. All right, it also stores calcium ions. In muscle cells, a special type of smooth ER called the sarcoplasmic reticulum is responsible for the storage of calcium ions that are needed to trigger the coordinated contractions of the muscle cells. So you must have, if you have followed my previous course that I did in physiology of muscle contraction, I have stated the importance of the calcium ions. So these calcium ions, they are kind of stored in the Golgi apparatus of the sarcoplasmic reticulum. Okay, so that's kind of related. If you want to have more information on this chapter, then you can check out my previous course, the Human Physiology Part 1, in which physiology of muscle contraction is perhaps the second chapter. There are also tiny smooth patches of ER found within the rough ER. These patches serve as exit sites for vesicles budding off from the rough ER and are called transitional ER. So on the endoplasmic reticulum, inside the rough endoplasmic reticulum, there are some patches which are like smooth patches on the ER. So these patches, they are kind of exit sites. Whenever a vesicle forms inside the rough endoplasmic reticulum, these vesicles, they exit through these smooth patches, and that is why these patches are termed as the transitional endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, so we now know the structure and the function, of course, of the endoplasmic reticulum. Now let's talk about the Golgi apparatus in detail. When vesicles bud off from the ER, where do they go? Before reaching the final destination, the lipids and proteins in the transport vesicles need to be sorted, packaged and tagged so that they wind up in the right place. Of course, because all the proteins, they have been synthesized for specific functions. So where does all this take place? This sorting, tagging, packaging and distribution takes place in the Golgi apparatus, an organelle which is made up of flattened discs of membrane. Okay, so where does the protein have to go? What does the function that it is to do? How it is supposed to be packaged? All this is decided inside the Golgi apparatus. The receiving site of the Golgi apparatus is called the cis phase, and the opposite is the trans phase. The transport vesicles from the ER travel to the cis phase, fuse with it and empty their contents into the lumen of the Golgi membrane. So once a vesicle is formed from the ER, it comes to the cis phase of the Golgi apparatus. There it fuses with it. All the contents in the vesicle, they are emptied inside the Golgi membrane. As proteins and lipids travel through the Golgi, they undergo further modifications. Short chains of sugar molecules might be added or removed, or phosphate groups attached to tags. Carbohydrate processing, shown in the diagram as the gain and loss of branches on the purple carbohydrate groups attached to the protein. So basically, all of this happens. The proteins get attached to the carbohydrates. The proteins may also get attached to the lipids. As such, packaging and, you know, specific functions are assigned to the proteins inside the Golgi apparatus. So finally, the modified proteins are sorted and packaged into vesicles that bud out from the transphase. So the vesicles enter through the cis phase, all the modifications undergo in the Golgi lumen, and then from the transphase, the modified, the sorted and the packaged proteins leave. Some of these vesicles deliver their contents to other parts of the cell where they will be used, such as lysosomes or vacuole. Others fuse with the plasma membrane, delivering membrane-anchored proteins that function there and release secreted proteins outside the cell. So cells that secrete many proteins, such as salivary gland cells, digestive enzymes, or cells of the immune system, have many Golgi stacks. So all these parts which have to have good functions in secretion, they have a number of Golgi stacks. In plant cells, the Golgi apparatus also makes polysaccharides, which are incorporated into the cell wall. Moving on, let's talk about the lysosomes. The lysosome is an organelle that contains digestive enzymes, and it acts as an organelle recycling facility of an animal cell. It breaks down old and unnecessary structures so that their molecules can be reused. So sometimes what happens is there is a lot of waste inside the cell. Of course, it performs a number of functions. So the remaining of residual mass inside the cell is obviously very natural. So where does all this residual mass go? It is digested by the lysosomes. So because it contains all the digestive enzymes, it acts as an organelle recycling facility. Lysosomes are a part of the endomembranal system, and some vesicles that leave the Golgi are bound for the lysosome. They can also digest foreign particles that are brought into the cell. As an example, let us consider a class of white blood cells called macrophages, which are a part of the human immune system. So these macrophages, as soon as they detect a foreign entry, they kind of phagocytose it. Okay, they eat it up. In a process known as phagocytosis, a section of the macrophage's plasma membrane invaginates, folds inward, and it engulfs a pathogen, just the way an amoeba would engulf food for itself. Okay, so these are the enzymatic bags which are present in the cell, lysosomes. The invaginated section with the pathogen inside pinches off from the plasma membrane to form a structure called the phagosome, and the phagosome then fuses with the lysosome, forming a combined compartment with digestive enzymes. They destroy the pathogen. So this is the way a lysosome works. Now let's talk about the vacuole. Plant cells do not have lysosomes. Instead, they have another type of organelle which is known as the vacuole. The large central vacuole stores water, and it wastes isolates hazardous materials and has enzymes that can break down macromolecules and cellular components like those of a lysosome. So just because plants don't have a lysosome to perform similar functions, we have a vacuole. Plant vacuoles also function in water balance and may be used to store the compounds such as toxins and pigments or colored particles. So if you remember in the study of the general cell, in the eukaryotic cell, we had studied the plant cell, and there was a big vacuole right in the center. So that's the central vacuole, and it kind of holds a lot of reserve water inside the cell. So that's about vacuoles. Now let's talk about lysosomes and peroxisomes. One point that can be confusing is the difference between the lysosomes and peroxisomes. Both type of organelles are involved in breaking down molecules and neutralizing hazards to the cell. Also, both usually show up as small round blobs in the diagram. However, peroxisome is a different organelle with its unique properties and role in the cell. It houses enzymes which are involved in oxidation reactions, and they produce hydrogen peroxide as a byproduct. The enzymes break down fatty acids and amino acids, and as they also detoxify some substances. So peroxisomes, unlike lysosomes, are not a part of the endomembranal system that we studied in the beginning itself. That means they don't receive vesicles from Golgi apparatus. All right. So this was the difference between a peroxisome and a lysosome. We have a quick diagram here. The central core of a peroxisome is made up of the urate oxidase crystalline core.